What's up, guys? Average Kiwi Guy here. How y'all doing? So it's Arrow Day, so you know what that means. We gotta watch the latest episode, and it was pretty darn good. I actually kind of enjoyed it. There are some problems that I'm still having with it. A little bit of clarification on where they're gonna go with, I think, with some major characters in this, universe, in this Green Arrow story and mythos and whatever you want to call it. This one answered a lot of important questions, like where they're gonna go with it. So as usual, guys, this is spoilers. This is big spoilers. If you have not seen this episode, go and watch it. It's actually pretty darn good. So if you're into Arrow, if you wanna see what happens, go and watch it. Then come on back. Come on back. Then you'll know exactly what we're talking about, okay? All right. So spoilers. Ready? All right, so second chances, which is pretty much all about the Team Arrow trying to find a new Black Canary. And all y'all know my feelings about the way they've treated Black Canary in this series. They treated her like garbage. They've treated her like garbage. They've got rid of Laurel. They killed her off. They killed off Laurel Lance. That's, that really pissed me off. I like this, TV show. I actually love it. It's really cool. But the fact that you treated Dinah Lance like that is bullshit. But they have done a little bit of a twisty thing, a bit of a twist to it, which is interesting what they've done. I'll give them that. But we'll get into that in a bit, near the end of this thing. So basically, all the guys are saying, showing all these like profiles, like, oh, this, she served 5 tours in Iraq. She's gold medalist in judo in the Olympics. She's pretty much perfect, right? Like the perfect, person to do this. He's like, nah. And then like all these people are like, nah. And he's like, look, we need to think outside the box here. We need to th think something different and all the rest of it. So Curtis goes, well, there's this woman here. We don't know her name. We have no idea who she is. But she can fight. She's been all over the country, saving people and protecting women and all the rest of it. She actually has her own cry, like canary cry. So maybe. So they're like, yeah, we'll go check her out. Obviously we'll go see what she's all about. And they go to Hub City. They find out who she is. Her name's Tina Boland, and she was Central City cop who was undercover in this gang that was running in Central City at the time when the particle accelerator exploded. So yeah, she's a metahuman. So this gang found out that she was undercover cop, had her trapped and everything, and they're torturing her and stuff. And the boss man comes in and has her partner, which is pretty much her like boyfriend as well. And he right when the particle accelerator explodes, he kills her, and she starts screaming. So that turns her into, Black Canary essentially, or Black Siren, whatever you want to call her. She gets the screech. So, and that's how she got her power. So she's a metahuman. So she's actually more similar to what the actual Black Canary is, with the fact that she has powers, but she's still not Laurel. And she can fight. She's pretty badass. She can do a whole bunch of stuff. She's really, really good. She's probably what Laurel should have been, probably by the previous season before she died. This is what Laurel should have been. She should have been this good. She should have been this powerful. She should have been this strong. This is what she should have been. But the fact that they killed her off, she never had that chance. So there's a really cool part where Arrow's trying to figure out like who this girl is, and they kind of they find her name, and they find out that she was a cop for the CCPD. And he rings up the commissioner, like the captain of the police, the station where Barry and all that and Joe and all that work. And we've seen him plenty of times in Flash. And he's like, look, hey, I'm the Arrow. I need your help. And he's like, yeah, please. You're just the guy with a, a voice, thing. It's like, huh. So he like texts Flash to say like, yo, can you like just do something for me real quick? And he like Flash zips in, puts a sticky note on his thing saying, yeah, it's him. Please help him. I was like, that's how close Barry and Oliver are. Oliver can just be like, yo, Barry, can you just do this for me right now? It was kind of a cool thing to me. It was just a small thing, but it's kind of cool. Like, that's where they are right now. Because in the comic books, that's what Arrow and Flash are. They're, him, Arrow, Green Arrow, Flash, Green Arrow, and Green Lantern are like tight buds. They're tight buds. They're like the triplets that are kind of together. They generally hang out together and all that. So it's kind of cool to see two of them, doing that. And obviously, maybe we'll see a Green Lantern later on. But it was kind of cool to see. I liked it. But yeah, like that's how he finds out that, who she was and like what she did and all that. So she's going on this vendetta to find these guys that killed her boyfriend, partner and all the rest of it. She's trying to find them. When they meet her the first time on the rooftops, she's like, what the hell are you supposed to be? Like what's all these costumes and stuff? And he's like, look, we can give you a home. Arrow's like, we can give you a home, we give you a second chance, you can come and help people and all this. And she's like, why the heck would I do that? And she screeches and beats them up and runs away. And pretty much this entire time, they're chasing her around Hub City, trying to find her. And it's like, ah, come on, man. So this big, like, gang guy is in Hub City because Tobias Church used to run Hub City, but now that he's dead because Prometheus killed him, he's trying to take over. And there's this new drug, another new drug, yes, called Slide. And apparently, Slide is meant to be that starting drug that gets you to the big stuff, gets kids young and gets them to the big stuff. So, like that, whatever. It's what they kept on saying all the time. And so she's like tracking down her henchman. Like he has this henchman, and they meet up with her again. And, like, find her apartment, and she's basically torturing him like this guy tortured her. And right when Arrow comes in, he's like, "Look, you don't have to do this. You don't have to be the bad guy and all the rest of it." Rah rah rah. She full on screeches him to death. Screeches him to death. Just shatters him. Like must shatter everything in his head because he's just like, "Ugh!" Or maybe the force of it like snaps his neck or something because he dead. He's dead. So she's got power. She's got a lot of power in that screech. And she always found. With Laurel, with the way they did Laurel, her screech never really had a power. It was just annoying. Like it was to distract people, or deter people. Like, ah, like my freaking ears, yo. But this one actually has force behind it. It's enough to blast people back and everything like that. So, like I said, this is a better version of what Laurel should have been. It's only till now that they figured it out, and they have to make another character to do this. It's like, come on. This should have been Laurel from the start, or Laurel from when she became Black Canary. Like, find a way to get her there. Like, maybe Laurel was in Central City when the damn thing exploded, and she starts getting powers. Do that way. But no, they went the other way, where she's inspired by her sister, and then they go that way. But it's all in the past now. We can't change it. But I still, this is what Laurel should have been. Anyway, like, she's, chasing around. And she, like, the bad guys show up and start shooting. And Wild Dog's with Arrow. And he's like, look, I'll handle these guys. She's jumped out the window. He's like, look, I can't let her go. Wild's like, look, I got this, guys. I got these guys. Don't worry. Wild Dog is actually useful in this one. He was actually useful and didn't get his ass beat. So there you go, Wild Dog. You're actually doing something. Congrats, bro. And she jumps out the window. She's running down the alleyway, and in probably one of the coolest things I've seen, because I'm a big fan of Green Arrow, he legit pulls a freaking boxing glove arrow, trick arrow. He shoots it. It slows down and shows the head change, and I'm pretty damn sure. I am so sure that that is a punk, like a fist, like a boxing glove. I was like, yes! The boxing glove trick arrow. And it works! It just knocks her down. She doesn't die, she doesn't get hurt. You know, it's just, oh, knocks her down. And, you know, of course, he suddenly appears after, you know, being like 20 feet up in the air in the on top of a building. You know, he's down right beside her now, but, you know, that's his arrow. You know, he used a grappling arrow. You know, must have. But, like, he legit pulls the boxing glove arrow. I was like, yes! Thank you. I know he's done. I've done like a thing where I think he stuck an arrow on the boxing glove and then shot it at a guy. But this was a legit trick arrow one. This is legit. He made one. I was like, yes, they're finally getting into these more, you know, little bit funny trick arrows that Green Arrow has and things. Because this is what Arrow Green Arrow is. He's all trick arrows. He's all the stuff with the bow and everything. So I'm glad they're getting into this. And they're making it, yeah, we're gonna throw the boxing glove thing in there. Yeah, it was a tiny little thing, but it was still the boxing glove. And I was like, yes, thank you. So that was pretty darn good. And you know, he's like, look. So he stops her and he's like talking to her, like, look, I know where you've been. You went through a traumatic experience. You've been through shit, you've been through some bad stuff, and you're struggling to deal with it. Like, you're struggling to figure out who you are, you know, who you've become in this way. And this was kind of the whole thing going through, like, and even if, you know, we'll go into like the past stuff with Talia and all that and the, you know, in a bit. But this was a whole thing referenced through, like, when you go through this stuff, maybe you don't become the, you know, you're not the person that you were when you went in, and you can't understand who you are, so these people act out. So this is kind of what she's going through. And he's like, look, I can help you. We can help you. This team is what we're kind of built around. And, you know, she's like, no. How far away is that sonic? They've got these sonic dampeners that can stop her from screeching all the time. And she's like, how far is that range on that sonic dampener that Wild Dog has all the way up in my apartment? And then Arrow's just like, okay, I get it. Like, backs off, and she kind of screeches, and he's like, God damn it, stop doing that. It would get annoying. It'd get really annoying. I don't know why they just don't wear earplugs. Why don't they have earplugs? Must be able to do something. I guess sonic waves goes past the eardrums and like resonates in your head, but I don't know. You figured they would have built something to, you know, they had one before. They had a canary before. Why not figure something else out to, you know, counter that? But, you know, I guess then bad guys would do that too. And what would be the point of Black Canary? So yeah, it must be impossible. Who knows? So they go through that, and she's still on this vendetta. She still wants to find him and all that, and she ends up finding him in his office. And guess what? He's a meta too. Because he was in that damn meta, you know, the big wave, the particle wave that came through. And he got powers as well. And it turns out her powers and his powers are connected. So he can harness sonic waves to like mess with your head. Like, kind of like in The Flash, there was that girl that could like make you feel like you have vertigo, like wicked vertigo, and it'd freak you out. Kind of that way. He messes with the you know, the stuff in your head that, you know, keeps your balance and stuff. And of course, Arrow's like a badass, and still like, oh yeah, I can handle this, and shoots him in the shoulder. And then like when he turns up the volume a little bit, that's when Arrow kind of gets a little bit shocked. But I was like, all right, you know, another, you know, obviously, I guess the two powers kind of, you know, affect each other. So he's kind of like the perfect counter, because when she shoots her screech at him, he can like kind of reverse it back at her, and that's kind of what he did. And yeah, so like Arrow and all that follows, and he's badass, shoots all that, and you know, Arrow shoots him in the shoulder, gets away, and they rescue her, get her out. So yeah, so they rescue her, they you know, they're in this thing, and they're like, look, darling. You have this badass screech, but he can counter that. That's a liability. You need my help. You need that help. And then Wild Thigh's like, look, man, if she wants to commit suicide, let her go. It's a free country. Let her do it. And I was like, okay. But Arrow's not going to do that. So they convince her to help, like for them to let him help and stuff. So they go up to this meet where they're going to get they're going to get more of this slide drug thing. And there's a whole bunch of dudes up on this roof. And they pretty much, it's Wild Dog, Black, well, not Black Canary right now, I guess Tina, and Arrow just going at probably like 10, 12 dudes and this like metahuman guy. And like, you know, everyone's shooting everyone. I do have a question though. Like, and I've wondered about this, about Wild Dog's guns. Is he, I think it'd be like Spartans. I guess it's like Spartans. Because like, I'm guessing they're either shooting in a place where they don't die. Or they're shooting rubber bullets. I think they're shooting rubber bullets. We'll go with that, right? Because they're not into killing. So, they're shooting rubber bullets. We'll go with that. And like, they're taking out dudes left, right, and center. And this helicopter. This straight up helicopter with guns and everything comes in and goes, like, starts mowing them down and stuff. And Arrow's like, look, I got this. I got this. Let me handle it. So he shoots a grappling arrow out, and he's like, and it hooks onto his bow and stuff. And he's like hard out using this helicopter. Like, it's just to make him look cooler. You know, do like the you know, hook him up to a line and stuff, and, you know, make him jump, and, you know, badass like punching, and like he's shooting while flying through the air, and he's throwing explosions. It was cool. I liked it. It was really, I love the fight scenes with Arrow because he's a regular dude. And this is what I kind of imagine, like what they would kind of do with Batman as well, in a way, but with a more Batman style. This is Green Arrow sort of thing. And the way they can do it with this whole, you know, I'm shooting explosive arrows, I'm shooting you in the shoulder, boom, 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 and punch while flying through the air with this helicopter. It's pretty cool. But then once he's done with that, he, like, straight up shoots an explosive arrow at the engines of the helicopter. And he straight up kills them. There's no, like, in-between with this. Because they're on top of this, probably like a 10-story building or something. They straight up go down and crash. While the engines are exploding. So, yeah, that did. So add that to another kill count, you know, for, you know, pilot and gunners on that helicopter. That's more for Green Arrow. But that's Green Arrow. Green Arrow's always been that guy that will, you know, he'll do that stuff sometimes. He'll do that stuff sometimes. And it gets him in trouble. It does get him in trouble. So they go up against the metahuman guy who's using the same thing. And Curtis, using his mind, thank you, because that's what he does. And this is the best thing that's happened past this mid-season finale is he's finally figured out, like, who he is. Dude, you're a freaking genius. You created a bionic chip to put him in Felicity's back to make her walk again. You're a smart-ass dude. Use it. Create gadgets. Do things like that. And they're finally letting him do that. And he, you know, he fixed the dampeners that they were using on Tina to work on him. So now he can't, do his sonic head thing. And Tina's pretty much got him pinned. He has him pinned, like, you know, straight up. He's standing there. She's got the gun pointed at him. And Arrow kind of does this, like, look, you don't have to do this. What would Vince do? Yes, the boyfriend's name was Vince. What would Vince do? And she sort of, like, looks at him. And then his strap just goes pop, 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 pop. Takes him out. And then just drops the gun. She's like, I want my revenge. I ain't listening to you. It's kind of like a Deadpool moment. You know, when, like, not as funny because Deadpool, you know, was hilarious. But, you know, like, when Colossus is trying to tell him, like, look, you don't have to kill him. You know, be the good man. And his strap just goes poof. Except Arrow didn't throw up. So, it was like that. And it was kind of good because, I mean, like, I don't, Oliver's not the most inspirational person. So I don't know how he would actually talk someone out of doing this stuff, especially when they've spent like the past like 3 years building up to this. So it was good that they realized, like, yeah, he can't do everything. So yeah, she straight up just kills him. Boom. So pretty much right at the end of this of the episode, they go to Oliver's office, you know, his Merrill office. And he, you know, he's still a bit down, like, damn, you know, I kind of messed up everything. And Tina shows up. She's, you know, walks in and she's kind of like, look, I thought revenge would be better than that. You know, I thought, you know, I'd kind of be free. You know, I'd know exactly what I was meant to do. But I'm kind of the same person. And I kind of got nothing to do now. And I don't know what to do. You know, you look like you got yourself sorted. You know what you're dealing with. And you're kind of containing that monster inside you and stuff. And, you know, Ollie's like, heck no, I don't know what the heck I'm doing half the time, you know, that sort of thing. But I know that this team is all about second chances. This is where, like, people can, you know, restart and make anew and all that stuff. And, you know, all the other guys have done it, you know, Wild Dog and all that, they did that. And, you know, it's like, you know, you can kind of be, you know, he sort of puts on her, like, you can be my second chance. Like, okay, you know, she's like, damn, that's a lot of pressure. Like, she's straight up like, you're gonna be my next Laurel. That sort of thing. I was like, that's a lot of pressure to put on someone brand new. That's a lot of pressure. And she's like, all right, you know, I'll join the team. You know, I'll become, you know, the next Black Canary and all that. Oh, and she's like, oh, by the way, my name isn't actually Tina. You know, this is just the name I use for my undercover stuff. It keeps my family safe and all that. My real name is Diana Drake. Diana Drake? I told you your name would be Diana, but I forgot all about Black Canary's mother. They're pulling, like, the reverse. So, for those who don't know, Diana Drake. She was in the Justice Society of America. She is Laurel Lance's mother. She was the very first Black Canary. This is what spurred Laurel to become Black Canary. You know, she that gave her the idea and stuff. And when Laurel got her powers and everything, that was what did it, you know? And so they're pulling the switch. They're switching it up. They're like, no, the mother. You know, the daughter was the first one before the mother's, like, technically name, you know? So Diana Drake was, you know, she was that before she became Diana Lance, because she married Larry Lance, who was the her, like, detective friend, her police officer friend that helped her out, and he helped out the JSA and all that. Yeah. She's Laurel, technically in the comics, she's Laurel's mother. And they have flipped it and made turned it into, you know what? We killed off Laurel, but we're gonna give you her mother's character instead. But the weirdest shit is the Laurel that we knew in the beginning of the series, so when she was Black Canary and stuff, is more like Diana Drake than what than what Diana Drake is now is more like Black Canary. They followed that way, but they switched the names. They switched the names. Really? You're gonna pull this? I mean, it's cool. I like the switch. I like how it's kind of different and it's interesting. And obviously, once you kill Laurel off, you have to bring someone in who's connected to the Black Canary name and all that. And you're not going to get more connected than Diana Drake. But this is like the third Diana that's technically connected to the Black Canary, because you've got Diana Lance, who was Laurel Lance's, who was actually her mother in the first. You know, when she, you know, an arrow when she was in the first thing. So technically her mother is Diana Lance, right? But now you bring in Diana Drake, who is technically Diana Lance. But, like, in this universe, in the Arrow universe, in this, you know, the whole CW universe, she's just some girl that's Diana Drake. And that's the way they're gonna make it. And I just think it's hilarious because the Laurel Lance that we've gotten used to with Arrow is essentially Diana Drake. She's Diana Drake didn't have powers. She was just a badass fighter with, you know, she could do all these cool things, and she had, like, this necklace on. She's pretty much she actually looks like, if you look at pictures of Diana Drake is Black Canary. She looks more like the actual, she looks like the Laurel Lance that we've been seeing in Arrow. So there you go. That was the big show for this thing. This was the big whole, like, what do you like? Everyone was asking, like, well, you just killed off Laurel. What the heck are you gonna do? You can't just get rid of Black Canary. That's not how it works. Like, how about this? Why don't we flip it and make it so that technically her mother's character becomes her character? So, yeah. Yeah. And of course, Ollie's like, huh, I knew a Diana once, and she's the whole reason I went and found you. It's like, how many of these goddamn people are named Diana? Everyone's named Diana in this damn series. I don't know. I like the move. Like, if you're gonna kill off Laurel, you might as well go with someone who's connected with the whole Black Canary story, which is true. This is, Diana Drake is very connected. She's essentially the first one. So, if you're gonna do something like this, you might as well use her. But I just think it's hilarious. You could have made the like Laurel who's gone. Like, if you literally took Laurel, who from season 1 to 3, you could have probably actually made her into Diana Drake. Like, make her just Diana, and her last name was Drake. Don't make her a Lance, but then obviously that would ruin Sarah and all that. But you could make her Diana Drake, and then turn this new one into Laurel Lance. You could do that. But that was the big show. That was the big whole, big thing at the end of this end thing. It was like, yep, she's Diana Drake. Okay. We'll see how they go. We'll see how they go. I'm still not happy with the way they treated Laurel or anything like that. This doesn't make up for that in any way. But it made me a little more interested into how they're gonna incorporate this girl. Is like, is she literally just gonna become her, like, become Laurel essentially from the comics? Like, is this where she's gonna be? And like Ollie and her and all that, this is what's gonna happen. Maybe that's what's gonna happen. So there you go. That's what it is. That's the way they've gone with it. It's interesting. It was definitely something that I didn't expect. I forgot all about Diana Drake. I jokingly said that her name was going to be Diana, and I forgot all about Diana Drake. And that's my bad. But yeah, so that was the big show. That was the big thing. So obviously we always have the flashback scene, the whole flashback storyline with this, and it always, coincides with what's going on in the present. So this was kind of how Ollie figures out how to control the monster that's inside of him, like how he learned to deal with it and stuff. So we immediately get caught back up because Talia saved him from the Bratva, who was going to kill him, the guy, the Bratva guy that was going to kill him. And she's like, you're a very interesting man, and I'm interested in you because I was Yao Fei's master. Like, I taught him everything. So those who can't remember, Yao Fei was the guy that saved him on the island on the first season. The original hood, the original guy in the hood with the bow and arrow and stuff. So that's pretty cool. That's whole linking into the whole thing. And he's like, there's no way. Yao Fei was old as hell. How are you like that? And she's like, well, I have my secrets. Maybe you're not the only monster here. So obviously the Lazarus pit, the Lazarus pit keeps her going, which could be interesting. Is there another Lazarus pit, or is she like, is this because obviously Ra's is still alive, so maybe she's still connected with the League of Assassins. So I'm not sure on that, but it could come into play. That could come into play that there are actually two Lazarus pits. So it would be interesting to see. But she's like, like, why haven't you gone home? You survived all these things, and she lists off all the things he survived. And he's like, look, well, I can't. I'm not that same person. I don't, I don't, I can't go back. I'm not like that anymore. And she's like, okay, well, and he's like, well, I need to kill Kovar anyway. You know, I promised someone that I would do it. And she's like, yeah. Well, why don't you help me help you sort of thing? So there's this slave trader, this guy that, you know, sells slaves, you know, girl sells girls to, you know, bad men and stuff, and he's a source of income for Kovar. Take him out. You know, I'll help him take him out. You know, we'll go together, we'll take him out, you know, all the rest of it. I'll take distract the guards, you kill him. And she pretty much takes him there, you know, they go to the thing. She's, you know, he looks at her with the bow and arrow, like, wait a minute, you're gonna go in with the bow and arrow? And she's like, look, I'm a badass. I can go in with a bow and arrow if I want. But yeah, she was like, oh, but you know, the person who uses a bow and arrow is a patience and all that, but she's a badass. She can do whatever she wants. And she, you know, she leads the guards away and stuff. And Ollie goes into this awesome fight with him just pop, 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 bang, you know, because he's got a gun. He's just bang, 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 kick, boom, boom. And he's like, guys are coming at him. He's just shoot, bang, bang, bang. Then, like, oh, out of bullets, grab, you know, grab that guy, grab his gun, boom, 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 boom. It was really cool. It was really cool to watch. I like that fight scene a lot. It was really, really awesome. And he, you know, the bad guy, the big guy, gets in this limo. And, you know, Ollie jumps in and he, like, looks at him and, like, the guy's pleading, like, look, anything you want, anything, girls, money, all the rest of it. And you think he's going to shoot him. But instead, he flips the gun up the other way with, you know, thing. And he literally pistol whips the guy to death. Ollie is, like, in this, like, time period, he is a beast. He's a beast. He rips people apart. He just beat the hell out of that guy. He's like unhinged. He's unhinged, man. And like, I think Talia sees that. She's like, look, yeah, you do have a monster inside of you. But maybe you should give it focus. And she sort of like, she takes him back to the thing and she's like, maybe you need to give a name to this monster. Give it a purpose. Like, you've been fighting all these men. You've been trying to find all the, you know, you fought all these people. You fought all the bad guys on the island. You know, all these people and stuff. Fight, fight, fight. You're trying to find the next person to fight. Well, you've had the people to fight all the time. And then obviously, that's the book with all the names in it. And he's like, you know, well, I can't, you know, that's not me anymore. I'm not the man that, you know, my father raised. I can't do that. Well, she's like, well, maybe you don't, you know, to be Oliver Queen, maybe you need to give this monster that's inside of you, like, a name. Give it a purpose. And, you know, she gives him the box that, you know, he come, you know, remember the box he always had in the first one with all the herbs and stuff? She, like, brings the box out. It was Yao Fei's box. And, you know, gives him the cloak and the hood and stuff. And he puts on the old gear, which looked a bit weird fitting on him now. It didn't quite look the same with it, you know, because now we're used to the green arrow leathers and stuff. It looked a little bit weird. But yeah, so this was sort of like, and like she's like, well, I'm gonna teach you how to do this, like how to, you know, to focus this monster. And yeah, that is legit. How I think this is gonna be how, you know, Ollie focuses in and actually goes about doing his business in Star City on the first season. So we're actually getting really close to them catching up to where we saw him when he was on the island and, you know, gets saved and comes back to Star City, Starling City, which is going to be very interesting. Very interesting what they do with that. Like, I guess we're not going to do flashback stuff no more, or maybe there's other stories that we're not seeing. But yeah, so they caught all back up. And it started to make me think that maybe Prometheus, right? You know how I said that maybe he could be Ra's. He could be Talia too. I wouldn't be surprised if it's Talia as, you know, maybe instead. Like, maybe this is Talia's way of getting revenge on him for him killing her father. That could be something. It'd probably be the most obvious thing that I can see. I would kind of like Ra's because Ra's is a bigger, you know, kind of bigger enemy, like bad guy, than what Talia is. Talia is always this character that's constantly in flux with, because she has these feelings for Bruce and for Batman and all that, and obviously, that relationship, literally the father of her child is Bruce Wayne, Batman. So one of the best, biggest heroes around. So she's kindly always in this tilt with, am I a bad guy or am I a good guy sort of thing. So I kind of want it to be Ra's because it's a big bad guy sort of thing. But I wouldn't be surprised if it's Talia. Talia kind of coming back and saying, I taught you everything. And this is how you repay me, by killing my father? No. That sort of thing. But yeah, so I wouldn't be surprised if it's Talia. But yeah, so that whole bit was sort of like building up to him becoming the Hood, and what we see in the first season. So we're catching up pretty darn quick to what we saw in season one. Also, the other small bit was they're still trying to get Diggle out of jail, and apparently the NSA is after the general. There was an investigation on him, but the apparently he like called up the higher ups, like, yo, stop this now. And they so the investigation got stopped. So Felicity's like, oh, I'll hack it. I'll go back to what I used to do and all that. And she hacks into the NSA and it's all gone. It's all gone. It's been scrubbed, everything, and she can't figure out why. And so she's all on the dark net, whatever, and hacking away. And this person's like, yo, are you this, like, what should they call her? Like, Fox Goddess Queen? Fox Queen Goddess? Something like that. Some weird name. That was her old hacker name from back in her college days. And she was like, you want to meet him in real life? They're like, what? You want to meet in real life and all that? And she takes Ragman along, and she's like, look, if things go bad, you crush this person. I know how bad these hacker people can be. And I swear to God, the damn younger version of Felicity shows up. There are two of them now. Two! I struggle enough with one of them. I don't need two Felicities. And she's like, look, I'm with this hacker group called Helix, which I'm still not sure, like, if it's going to be a thing later on, because they, like, hacked the NSA. They, took all these files out and all the rest of it. And they're going to, like, start revolutions and all that. And I think she's trying to get Felicity to, like, join them and become, like, a member of this Helix group. And she's like, look, your friend's things are on here. Here you go. But like, she's like a mega fan of Felicity, like mega fan, like knows what she did, all the rest of it, all her big hacks. And she's sort of like, well, where you been? Like, what you been doing? It's like, I know you were running Palmer Corp, but I thought after you'd been fired, you would like come back and, do all this, do all the hacking stuff again. She's like, well, I've been busy. And she sort of like makes her out to be like, that whole like, you got old sort of thing. But I was like, God damn it, I don't need to see another freaking Felicity. I don't need two. I don't need two. So they get this USB drive that's apparently full of NSA secrets. And she plugs, she goes to Oliver, like, Oliver just got back from Hub City, and she's like, look, I got this stuff, I can free dig. Yay, and all the rest of it. And she plugs it in. Like, I'm gonna leak it to people so that, they get fired, they'll go and get the general and stuff. And you just see her plug it in. For one thing, right? I will not trust anything that hackers give me to plug into my computer. Why would you do that? There must be some way to like scrub it or, put it into a system that they can't get into or it won't affect anything else. You're plugging it into essentially like the Arrow's version of the Bat computer. And it's just like this, oh yeah, here's this hacker's USB drive. How many times have we seen when they plug a USB drive into things, it suddenly all gets hacked? I would not be cool with that. I would be like, yo, well, wait, hang on a minute. We're plugging something from someone else into our computer that apparently has every answer that we need? No. We're finding another way. Felicity, go get a whole bunch of other computers. We'll find it on that. We'll isolate it. You know, that sort of thing. I've seen too many damn like hacker things and, you know, AI shit to know that you don't plug in USB stuff from hacker people. You don't do that. So she like plugs it in as, you know, typical Felicity just plugs it in and like all these secrets start flowing past her, you know, glasses and stuff. So obviously she wants to get back into her hacking stuff again. So maybe she'll go with Helix for a while, maybe. I don't know. But I just hope they don't try and turn her into Oracle. Don't turn her into Oracle. Felicity is no Oracle. Mm-mm. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm. You already tried it when you paralyzed her. Do not try it again with this hacking stuff. Uh-uh. She's no Barbara Gordon. No way. But yeah, so that was kind of like Felicity's little story and stuff. And they get dig out. Dig gets because you know all they find out all this stuff was fake against Dig and all the rest of it. He gets out on bail. So obviously there's gonna be like you know courts things and stuff like what actually happened. But yeah, he gets to get out and he's in, you know out of jail and stuff. So yay, because technically Dig did break out of prison. Technically did break out of prison. So that's illegal in itself. So I don't know what they'll do with that. He'll get out. He'll get out. He's a too big a character to leave stuck in the thing. But yeah. So there you go. That was the entire thing. That was pretty much all the interesting parts anyway. There's a kind of other little things where like Wild Dog kind of figures out that the team's a second chance thing and you know, and Curtis kind of figuring out who he is and stuff. So, but yeah, that was Second Chances. So they went with Diana Drake to replace Laurel. If I was ever gonna be okay with it would be if they used Diana Drake. If I was ever gonna be okay with it, I would be more okay with it if they did try and get Black Siren to become Black Canary. But they obviously have moved on from that because they're like, then they wouldn't waste Diana Drake on this without thinking that she's going to stick around for a while. She just wouldn't. Maybe like there'll come a point where Black Siren and her will fight, and whoever wins becomes Black Canary, sort of thing. But I don't know. I don't know. I just don't. I'm still pissed that the way they treated Laurel. But if I was ever gonna be okay with it, and I'm not, but if I was ever gonna be okay with it, at least they had the decency to go out and find someone connected to Black Canary's, that directly connected to Black Canary's story. They just didn't make up another character. And thank God they didn't do that because there is a point there through that episode where it's like, God damn it, this Tina lady doesn't even exist in the DC universe. She doesn't even exist. Why are they making her Black Canary? So thank God they did that. Thank God they did bring out Diana Drake. The flashback stuff was interesting, obviously with Talia. I'm really excited that she's here now. I always thought she should have been there anyway. I don't know why they used Nyssa. But yeah, so they used. Thank God Talia's here now. And yeah, I could do with less Felicity. Once again, I could do with less of her. All right, guys, that's it for me. Thank you for watching. I really do appreciate it. Hit that subscribe button. We've had a lot of new subscribers over the past few weeks, so thank you guys. I really appreciate it. Welcome to it. If you guys are watching, welcome. Thank you guys for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button. A lot of people are. Come join the community. Come join the Kiwis here. This is a weekly thing, so that way you know, if you do subscribe, you'll know when it comes when the video goes live right away. So that'd be cool. I'm glad you guys are enjoying this sort of stuff. I do enjoy it. I do enjoy doing this, so it'll definitely be a regular thing. The new Flash reaction is out, so go check that out too. Hit the likes and the comments on that one as well as this one. That way more people see this video. We've also got gaming content up. We've got stuff of Honor, Pit People, all the new stuff that's coming out. It's all there. So go check that out. Go check us out on socials. That's Average Kiwi Guy, all on the socials, pretty much all of them. Go check that out. Twitter, everything. And also check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/AverageKiwiGuy07. Stream pretty much there every week, so go check us out there. Hit that follow button. That way you know when I go live. And yeah. So I hope you guys are having a good day, good night, wherever you are in the world. And I'll catch us next time. Peace.